you have to be between 40 and 75 years old, of good repute, and a Muslim. You must also have at least a master's degree and 4 years in higher management. But some 80 people applied for a chance to lead Iran under its supreme leader, Ayatollah Ali Khamenei. And only 6 got approved. So quite a few unwritten factors also appear to be requirements. Being a man, conservative, and hardline clearly helps. Ties to key institutions in Iran, either the clergy or the Islamic Revolution Guards Corps, are useful, if not crucial. Being the sole reformist candidate might help, given the conservative vote is split. However, Masoud Pezeshkian will have to convince disenchanted Iranians to go out and vote. Some candidates are hoping to boost their chances by promising to follow in former President Ebrahim Raisi's footsteps. Supreme Leader Khamenei has so far refrained from endorsing any candidate, but his supporters believe his descriptions of an ideal candidate, like revolutionary and hardworking, denote hardline candidates. Friday's sermons mention a president who won't change Raisi's path and who will obey the Supreme Leader. Subtle signs, perhaps. Many think Mohammad Baqir Ghalibaf most meets these criteria. Most of all, a successful candidate must convince people to vote. Parliamentary elections in March saw a record low of 41% turnout. If that apathy continues, whoever wins the presidency, it will undermine their legitimacy.